Micheál McLafferty's with me here. He got a tremendous vote and still in the shake-up there to some extent, Micheál. But first of all, you must be absolutely delighted with the response you've got here.
Totally, totally over the moon, Charlie, altogether. Great. Far more than ever anticipated. First time out, of course, everything else, independent. But just I really, really have to thank, first of all, the team behind me. My mum as well, equally. My mum first of all. Yeah. Secondly, my team that is great behind me, friends, neighbour, family, they really supported me. And overall, I need to the big thank you goes to all the people who trusted me, had the faith in me, voted for me on Friday. That was the main one. So brilliant to be here tonight. Glad to be here, and just I wish all the other candidates now well, and hopefully. But I know there's some new faces going on. Hopefully that it'll make a shake-up on things in the local as well as national eventually, and that we try and get things turned around, because at the moment here in Donegal, we're suffering, we're on our knees. Young people are immigrating. The government in Dublin aren't listening. It's just the whole thing's a mess. And austerity, you cannot tax your way out of a recession. That seems to be the attitude at the moment with the current government. It's not going to work. It's just, we can't do it. So hopefully today that some good has come out of it in that respect itself.
Tell me, Michael, I mean, it's a big decision to put yourself on that ballot sheet if you haven't been involved in politics before.
Yes.
You've mentioned a lot of the things that are wrong. Were they the main motivation factors for you to decide, right, I'm going to give the people the opportunity to elect me here?
More or less, yes. The main factors were because of the cuts, because of the household tax, property taxes. You know, that's when I initially got involved. That was my first role into starting on the road to politics, if you like. Secondly as well, then more importantly, which based the big thing that I ran on here today over the last 5 weeks or so out canvassing, 6 weeks canvassing, was that I would like to see an air ambulance coming to Donegal. I think the people of Donegal were getting hammered right, left and centre in the HSE end of it. Many fronts, to be fair, but I think if you really want to pick any front, we'll all agree, health starts first. From our hospitals, to our hospices, to our nursing homes, to our home helps, to elderly in general, rural isolation. They're getting a hammering, and the boys in government don't seem to realise, they don't care, they don't understand. Okay, some people have said to me in the doors, you're asking a lot for a helicopter. Not really. A helicopter coming about probably about 4 million or thereabouts for an air ambulance. Any of the ambulances in the Kenny to Merns, carried out from bumper to bumper, they're sitting at a quarter of a million.
Yeah.
An air ambulance, the benefit of an air ambulance, speed, saves lives. What respect that Letterkenny Hospital ambulance is best, great, can't fault them, but where we live here geographically, we're half an hour to 40 minutes away. That could be the difference between somebody living and somebody dying.
Sure.
And also with the new cuts, or the new set of ways going on, or the new rule they're bringing in now, sending the ambulance before the now doc is ridiculous.
Sure.
Because that's definitely going to put people's lives on the line.
Was the medical card situation an issue with you
big
out
issue
there?
As well, yes, I've been running the medical card situation as well. Another issue I've been running on as well, that probably most people aren't aware of, or some are, to be fair, but it's not. I would like to see it more out there, is fibromyalgia awareness, a condition that a lot of young women get, particularly here in Ireland, because of the weather being so damp. It's an invisible disease, if you like. A lot of people aren't aware of it. One good thing I will say is, two good things have come out of it. People really think the air ambulance is a brilliant idea in the doors. Secondly to that, then, a lot of people have been curious, asked what is fibromyalgia, and then the medical card as well, that I'm fighting for that, helping people out with that, is going down,
sure,
going down good as well. The most, the best highlight is the most out of the whole campaign. I've loved it from start to finish, but the most best highlight out of the whole thing was, come on, I knocked on the door one night, and this lady came out to the door. She's living in Donegal here now some years, and I just introduced myself, and the thing is, handed her the leaflet, and she was reading the leaflet as she was talking to me, and she just says, you go for your ambulance, and I says, yes. I says, okay, I says, like everybody else, is a big gas, but
yeah,
I think it can be achieved.
Yeah.
And she's not really, she says, where I left in Devon and Cumbria in England, my friend over there, she was the first over there to lobby for it and campaign for it. Now there's 3 residents in that area over there. So she says, keep it up, keep at it, and she says, it's not impossible. I don't feel myself it is impossible, but I would like more people in Donegal here to get behind things, get behind the health service. A lot of young nurses have told me as well in the doors, which I was shocked at as well. If you study in Ireland here to become a nurse, go to your college, do everything else, get your degree, spend your 4 years, 5 years in some cases, and get your nursing license, and you spend maybe 80% of your time in the hospital, practical and theory, etc. If you come out with your license in your back pocket and you go to work in the HSE, you're being asked then to work for €5.60 an hour, whereas your wage should be up at €20 an hour. But because the HSE ties you into a two-year contract, you're tied then to €5.60. And like, to be fair, there's no recognition whatsoever on what those nurses do, those doctors do. They're working in there in the hospital 12 hours shifts plus. Sometimes they're not even getting tea breaks. I was in there some weeks ago myself and my own uncle who went in with a problem, and the help that he got was second to none. Like.